and just give it a second.
Hello, and welcome to our presentation of 5678 Die, my new play, or with our little company that we're doing these plays month to month. We'd like to remind you before we get started that today is a charitable event. We're giving money over to the Act Blue bail funds that are bailing out protesters for Black Lives Matter around the country. You can send it to our Venmo right here. Look at that. Sweet Nail Product. And it's a suggested donation of $20. We'd really like to raise a lot of money for Act Blue today. We love getting together and do these plays, but we'd really like to make a big difference in the world. So if you can please give as much as you can, we'd like to give a lot of money to Act Blue today. Also, I know, girl, wait until you see this wig. The wigs today are really half the show. I say that, wearing my wig. So before we get started, we'd like to announce that there'll be a brief intermission at the end of Act One for 5 minutes. My wonderful friend Luis and I will be talking about future productions and answering all your questions. So if you have any questions during the show, please make sure you put them in the YouTube comments. We'll get to them at intermission, quick 5 minute intermission, where we can also remind you how to give all that money. And without further ado, 5678 Die.
5678 Die by Justin Sayre. Interior, MorningStar Studio. Mr. Jeremy A. Tans, 40, the dance instructor, is pacing in front of the mirror talking to his class of preteens. He's a slight homosexual with the look of a very wet Persian cat.
Now, today we are sad. I know it. I feel it. Gemma was a leader, but she was not the only one. All my girls are leaders, even you, Toby.
Toby, 11, looks up from his cross-legged pose on the floor and smiles just to be acknowledged.
Now, Gemma was irreplaceable, and we will always hold her here, you know, in our hearts. But she's gone. Gone, y'all. They have dragged the river. They have dug up the yard. That girl is nowhere to be found.
Belef Bludschart, 42, a woman dressed for a casino, stands up and interrupts her partner.
And that is sad.
Of course that's sad. I'm saying it's sad.
I'm also saying so, for emphasis.
Well, then we agree.
We always do.
Fendi Melandro, 11, raises her hand from the floor, the seedling of a real bitch in high school.
So does this mean there'll be a new captain for regionals?
From the back of the room, Lurline Melandro, 42, a pastel blonde important enough to have a BlackBerry in a very small town, looks up from her phone.
Fendi, honey, you need to be patient. That girl died.
Gemma is still missing. Nobody has confirmed or can confirm that she is actually...
Sitting next to Lurline, Patty Beth Scruggs, 42, is picking her teeth with a pocket knife.
Oh, come on, Bella. That girl's either dead or in a cult somewhere.
Ramada Scruggs, 12, turns back to her mother.
Mama, what's a cult?
Oh, you know how Uncle Eric can't never get a beer, even at Christmas? That's a cult.
I think we're losing focus. We're here to celebrate the life of young Gemma.
Because it's over? You hear yourself? I mean, come fucking on.
I think it's sad. I mean, I'm sad about it. But also, with a mama like that, would you really stick around?
All right, silence. Silence, y'all. This is my studio, all right? You will not desecrate my temple with your lollygagging jibber-jabber and your flim-flam-falderol.
There's a shocked silence. Suddenly, Fudgy Dwyer, 36, and her daughter, Michaela, 11, burst through the door, running late. They brought a tray of brownies to apologize.
Sorry I'm late, y'all. My mama's incontinence has gotten real vindictive recently, and I just can't have that minivan shampooed again. Michaela Peanut, go on, sit with the other girls.
Michaela moves to sit down.
Now hurry up, Michaela. You know how I feel about tardiness.
Oh, mama says you're not allowed to call me that.
Belef tries to step in.
Irregardless, we've got to carry on. Now, right now, we are broken. We are shards of a fallen chandelier that lies jagged on the ugly on our beautiful parquet floor.
So we're a chandelier that also owns the house?
You're going to call me out for mixing metaphors when one of your kids got the same daddy?
Lurline puts down her phone. Fudgy drops the trail mix she's eating out of a bag.
Now, I am trying to build my team here, and y'all ain't giving me nothing to work with.
We're all of us real sorry, Mr. Jeremy. We want to believe. I know we all do, don't we?
I know I do.
Mm-hmm.
Now, of course you do, dear sweet Toby. You are devoted to this place because it's the only home you'll ever know. You don't have one of these mamas back there telling you that you're the best, AKA lying to your face. If it means something to y'all, I need you know now. All right? Or I might as well just pack up my bag and go home and watch my programs.
You have us, Mr. Jeremy. We're here. We want to be here.
Do you, Ramada? Do you? Because I don't feel it, Ramada.
We're here. We want to be here.
Them's pretty words, Fendi, but so are most lies, and you're a little liar.
I'm Michaela.
And boom goes the moron. Y'all, you need to get your head screwed on straight because I need your whole head in this game. And not just that head. I need your body. I need your mind and your soul in this room. All right? This has got to be the only place that matters to you from now on. What happens outside those doors? It don't matter. There's only here.
We only want to be here.
I need to go toilet.
Y'all need to convince Mr. Jeremy this is where y'all want to be, okay?
It matters.
We're here.
Okay, and not just y'all mamas, huh?
I'm here.
And I brought sugar cookies in case anybody wants.
All right. Thank you. That is what I need, y'all. If you give me your time, money, and attention, all right? As well as the mind, body, and spirit I mentioned before. Yeah, regionals is just the beginning of what y'all can do. Can y'all do that?
Yeah.
Okay, good, good. But before we get all into that, we want to watch a little video remembrance of our sweet friend, Gemma Lockery.
Elif pops on the tape and Gemma, 12, appears on screen. A young girl in a glittery outfit, she starts to dance.
Look at her, my word. Oh, such a shame she's gone. How can we replace her?
That ain't my job. That's yours. Now get on it.
Exterior, Piggly Wiggly. Becky Lockery, 41, frantically hands out flyers with Gemma's pictures on them.
If there were a coupon, you'd take it.
It's just
my daughter's missing.
Becky continues to try to get anyone to help her as Allison Newington, 30s, a second standby for a host of single moms movies, drags her moody daughter Kimberly out the grocery store in a whispered panic.
If you wanted Funyuns, why didn't you just ask? You don't have to shoplift, Kimberly.
Wasn't God, why do you have to freak out?
I am not freaking out. My chakras are aligned and I am at peace. I am working in my way toward a better day for myself and all peoples. I am centered. I am peace.
You're annoying.
Go wait in the car. I can't believe I can't trust my own daughter in a grocery store.
Becky makes her way over to them. Kimberly walks to the car.
Daughter? I have a daughter, or I had one, my little Gemma. She's been missing for a while now, and nobody seem to care, nobody.
Your daughter is missing. Have you called the police?
You can see me? Sorry, I'm sorry. It's just that the rest of these heartless bastards is acting like I ain't even here. You want to take a flyer?
Becky hands Allison a flyer.
Oh, she's just a little girl.
Oh, no, she was a dancer. She it was her whole life, and now I worry that she ain't got no life at all. Hmm. You know, like maybe she's dead.
Yes, I was following.
Okay. Sorry. Well, like I said, nobody's been talking to me. Like nobody at all. And it kind of makes you a little off, you know.
Kimberly comes back
annoyed. I can't get into the car. I need the keys.
Here, but don't turn it on.
Fine.
He seems like a handful.
Yeah, puberty is a bitch. And so is she most days. So it's a match made in hell. When did Gemma disappear?
She's been gone a whole week, but nobody care. Folks is acting like I'm making it up.
Why? You would have to be some sort of sociopath.
Well, they might have me there. I've done some pretty fucked up shit. You ever seen that show Weeds? Like that, but with meth and way more off the rails. But that don't got nothing to do with my baby girl. I mean, Gemma's been missing 8 days now, and folks what know me knows I ain't got the attention span for this if it weren't, you know, true.
You know, maybe I can help. I'm a bit of a psychic.
Like a Ouija board or some shit?
No, I work with energies. You don't have anything that belongs to her, do you?
Becky reaches into her pocket.
I got her flipper. She wore them at her dance shows.
Fake children's teeth. You could have taken a hair clip or a pencil, but sure, let's go gross early.
Allison holds the teeth for a moment and gets a flash of Gemma trapped somewhere. Allison is shocked.
What did you see?
I don't know. I've never seen anything like it before.
Is she alive?
I don't know. I just don't know.
Exterior Allison's house later. Allison carries the groceries into the house as Kimberly barely helps.
Kimberly, can you please help me with the groceries? I honestly don't know what's wrong with you anymore.
I'm acting out because I'm in a moment of hormonal shift in an uncertain emotional landscape. It's like textbook.
Sounds it. Can we please have this tantrum inside? My Dove bars are melting.
Sure, Mom. Your Dove bars, your Activa, your LaCroix, they're all more important than me, aren't they?
No, they just have to be refrigerated. How am I supposed to be a white lady without white lady foods?
I am like literally crying out for help.
Kimberly squats down to sit on the driveway.
All right. What's wrong?
I know you think I'm being like a total bitch or whatever, but I don't like being like this, you know?
I still think you have issues with blood sugar.
Well, I wouldn't if I got those effing Funyuns.
Listen, I know the move has been tough on you. You didn't want to leave your dad, but I couldn't stay in a marriage with someone like that. The ponytail, the tuba lessons, the suspenders, and a belt. I mean, your whole life can't just be about irony, Kevin.
It was a toxic environment, I get it.
We were one homebrew away from living in a tiny house. I know this is a difficult time for you, honey. You've moved to a new town where you don't know anybody, and it's summer, so it's harder to make friends.
Are you saying I'm ugly?
I wasn't saying that in any possible way. Maybe there's something we can do to make it a little easier.
You already said you won't let me get my nose pierced, so how will people know I'm interesting?
Well, what about an activity or a club? Nothing where you have to sell cookies, because I'm not up for that kind of commitment yet, but there's gotta be a theater camp around here somewhere. Little gay boys will love you.
I don't know. It's not really my thing.
But maybe it could be your thing. I mean, we're in a new town. Why can't we be new people? Hello, my lady. I'm Nigella Sapperstein.
Mom, stop.
All right, no accents, but maybe a different outlook? I don't know. You know, you could be a girl who smiles and has a much better attitude, and I could be, I don't know.
Less of a...
Wow. Seriously, I am a human being. Let's think on it, okay? Now, can we please just get these groceries inside? My pumpkin spice spilled all over my bag and honestly, almost making me want to eat everything in there.
Kimberly goes to pick up the bag and the flyer from Becky.
You still want this stupid flyer?
Oh, that poor woman and her poor girl. She's in a lot of danger wherever she is.
I like her costume though. Maybe I could like dance or something.
Really? You'd have to smile a lot. Do you think you'd be up for that?
Well, not when you say it like that. God, why do you hate me?
Kimberly drops her groceries and runs into the house.
Kimberly, you're lucky that wine was in a box.
Allison picks up the groceries and heads inside. Interior MorningStar office the next day. Allison and Kimberly sit in the office waiting for Miss Belef to return from the back room. Toby seats them and stands watch.
Do you smell that? It smells like something's on fire.
Stop freaking me out.
Miss Belef will be with you in just a moment.
Do you take classes here?
Yes. I'm one of Mr. Jeremy's most favorite minions.
That doesn't sound weird at all. You sure you don't want to play volleyball or something?
Belle F enters with a box of Lean Cuisine and opens it as she talks.
Sorry to keep y'all waiting, but I just need to grab Miss Francine her lunch, okay? Now, were you real nice to our guests, Toby? Yeah.
Huh? Belle F puts it in the microwave.
Yes, Miss Belle F, ma'am.
Toby's one of our little fallen angels, a gift dropped right from heaven that didn't nobody want. Toby here's an orphan.
My birth mommy loves smack.
She did. Mr. Jeremy and I adopt these talented little scraps to save them from being just another senseless abortion. Now run on back to class, Toby. Mr. Jeremy is waiting for you.
Elleth starts to sit down when the sound of the microwave is heard.
Oh, my goodness. Does it ever end? One more second. I need to get her Lean Cuisine while it's still lava.
Belleth gets up to get the hot Lean Cuisine, unlocks the inner office door, and goes in. There's a sound of a scuffle, mumbled curses, and then a struggle. Things shake. The desk is moved. Then nothing. Belleth re-enters, straightening her hair and settling down to talk to her new prospective stars.
Okay. I told her it was too hot, but she's just gotta dive in right in head first.
Miss Francine is the owner?
Oh, no, she's a dog. Yeah. I am the owner, okay? She's a dog. Mr. Jeremy lets me keep her there in the office. I'm the owner, me, Belle F. Bloodshart.
Well, nice to meet you, Miss Bloodshart. I'm Allison.
I'm sorry, it's Bloodshart. I don't put in that umlaut for my health. And your name is?
I'm Allison Newington, and this is my daughter, Kimberly.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Okay, I wrote it down before we spoke on the phone, but I just needed you to say it out loud so I know I'm doing it right. Okay, so you say it just like you spell it, right? Is that right?
That's correct, yes.
Unoriginal. Well, hello, Newingtons. What dream can I make come true for y'all today?
Well, my daughter Kimberly is interested in taking some dance classes.
Does she speak? I mean, it don't matter either way, but we do like to know about our dancer's special needs up front.
Hey.
Well, there she is. Well, hello, Miss Kimberly. Don't you seem all broody? I bet it was either this or go shooting up a high school.
Hasn't gotten that bad. Has it?
No, God, Mom.
Oh, no, ma'am. No, ma'am. No, we do not use that name lightly around here or at all.
Kimberly, apologize. I raised my daughter to respect all religions. I'm Wiccan. I got certified on Goop.
Well, if it ain't Baptist, it don't count. But as long as you're here, you'll respect the man upstairs enough to never, ever, ever say his name again or mention him again. Am I making myself clear?
Yes. Ma'am, I'm sorry.
Good. Now, Kimberly, your mother tells me you would like to dance with us here at MorningStar Dance Academy and Modeling. Is that true?
Go on, Kimber.
Legally, now here's the thing. I need to hear it from you, Kimber. And it's all right if you don't. I see quitters every day. I mean, you can't run around this town but once and count more of them on the hands than you got fingers on them hands, okay? But here at MorningStar, we're different. We're looking for commitment, belief, fortitude. You ever had yourself some of them?
I don't know. I guess.
Well, you know what? If you did, there'd be no guessing about it. Now, do you want this, Kimberly, or is Mommy forcing you to do this to live out some of her unfulfilled dreams?
I'm sorry. I'm very fulfilled. I'm carrying a jade egg as we speak.
I don't, nor do I want to know what that is. Thank you. So, which is it, Kimberly?
I just want to dance.
I don't believe you just want to do anything. I believe you want it as bad as you want to see your daddy again. As badly as you want to get out of this shithole town and maybe major in political science because you're secretly obsessed with orangutans and you want to do your damnedest to save them. Am I right?
Yes. Have you been reading my journal?
Oh, I see your soul, honey. And your soul says, I want to dance. Just a shame your mouth won't do the same.
I want to dance.
Louder!
I want to dance!
Too loud! So, the first class is $2,500 payable now, preferably with cash, and we share a parking lot with the Indian restaurant next door, so we can't validate.
Okay, I hope you take cards.
Of course we do, but only Discover. They remind us of the 70s. Kimberly, you've made the right decision, and you've made a lucky decision. We are looking for a new captain in our very elite Five Alive company. They're going to regionals this year.
Mom, regionals.
The group is taught by Mr. Jeremy himself.
Mom, Mr. Jeremy, you don't know who he is.
Oh, well, Mr. Jeremy is maestro of this little dance studio. Well, you know what? I shouldn't even say little, as we are ranked number one in the state.
Mom, they're number one.
You stop pulling at my clothes. Well, that is a very nice offer, but Kimberly's never taken a dance class before.
Mom!
Oh, you don't need to worry none about that. Mr. Jeremy builds on natural talent. Well, I've seen girls come in here not knowing which way was down till they fell on over. And each and every time, he has taken that awkward, pimply, knock-kneed little freak and turned her into pure jazzmatazz.
I want that. I want to be jazzmatazz.
I had a feeling you did. Now, Mr. Jeremy's teaching the Five Alive right now. Why don't we just hop on in there and see if he can audition you right quick?
Mom, can I?
I honestly don't know. Can you?
There's only one spot available. And who knows when there'll be another opportunity like this.
Mom, please.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. Miss Francine, now I'm going to go in to take these girls to the studio and introduce a new dancer to Mr. Jeremy, okay? You just finish that lean cuisine, and I'll be back to wipe you on up.
There's a pound at the door.
Ugh, tops or tails, there's going to be a mess in there somehow. Ugh, shall we?
Belleth goes out into the hall. Allison and Kimberly follow her. Interior Morningstar hallway. Belleth walks into the studio and raving about Mr. Jeremy.
Oh, Mr. Jeremy is a genius when it comes to prepubescent dance. People have compared him to Jerome Robbins, okay? That's huge. Y'all, that's West Side.
Belleth opens the door on Mr. Jeremy teaching the Five Alive. Suddenly, a huge whiff of sulfur hits Allison and she starts to get queasy. Oh. Interior of the studio. Belleth enters the room and Allison is almost passing out.
Oh my God, can no one else smell that? It's like the fart after you die.
Mom, you're embarrassing me.
Mr. Jeremy, this is little Kimberly and her mother, Allison, who can go down to the bathroom down to the hall if she's going to take sick.
It's tinged with death and like Marmite?
Belleth walks Kimberly toward Mr. Jeremy. Ramada, Toby, Michaela, and Fendi all sit on the floor cross-legged.
Kimberly. That's a name. So you want to dance for Mr. Jeremy, do you?
Well,
because Mr. Jeremy don't train dancers. Mr. Jeremy makes entertainers. What do I do?
Mr. Jeremy makes entertainers.
That's me. I'm Mr. Jeremy. Now, when a girl comes to me, I give her poise. I give her sass. I give her sparkle. But I can't give her nothing if she doesn't have, what, y'all?
Heart.
That's right. H-E-A-R-T. Head to learn. Ears to listen. Attitude to strike. Respect for herself and her team. And talent. Do you have heart, Kimberly? You have what it takes?
Well, Kimberly's never danced before.
But I can try. I want to try.
Sounds like there's some heart in there somewhere. Lurleen, honey, would you press play on the tape, please? Let's see what you can do. Kimberly, the floor is yours.
Mr. Jeremy moves back to watch Kimberly dance.
You just want me to dance right here, right now?
You want to be a part of my group? I need to see what you bring to the table.
Jeremy goes back to the room. The lights go out with a snap, and Florence and the Machine's Seven Devils starts to play. Kimberly starts to dance, slightly at first, but then becomes better and better. The girls and Toby start watching each with their own reaction. Fendi is jealous. Ramada is excited. Michaela tries to follow along with her on the floor. Toby smiles. Kimberly does a pirouette and continues to spin.
Mr. Jeremy, I thought you might like her.
Oh, she's perfect.
Mm-hmm. Kimberly continues to spin and stops. She looks into the mirror, transformed. Exterior MorningStar parking lot. Allison is hunched over as John brings her a glass of water.
Here, drink this. You sure you don't want to come in and sit down?
No, but thank you for the copper cup the metal promotes.
Circulatory help and a more balanced elemental chart.
You know your stuff. Well, really your culture.
No, I'm black. I just work at an Indian restaurant. We can do anything. But I also teach a little yoga on the side.
Oh God, not there, I hope.
You smelled it, didn't you?
How could you not? It's like what you think a melting gremlin smelled like.
See, I went with the end of Roger Rabbit, but why did so many people melt in the 80s? Anyways, I'm John, by the way.
Allison.
Belleth walks Allison and Kimberly to their car.
I'm so sorry, honey. I really don't know what came over me. How did you do?
I made it. I'm in the five alive.
Oh. I'm just sorry you missed seeing this little superstar knock everybody's socks off in there. Uh-oh. Hey, John. Is that a samosa in your apron, or are you just thinking about what happens one of these days when I finally pounce all up on you?
No. I have a taser, and you know why. Glad you're feeling better, Allison. Smell you later.
Mom, pay attention to me. I'm imprinting shame right now.
You did great. You are great. I am so proud of you for doing whatever you did. What exactly did she do?
She wowed is what she did. She's danced like nothing we'd ever seen. Now, she is starting off here. But she could be up here, okay? But to get there, she needs to be here every day, 5 days a week, 2:30 to 6, and we will not feed her.
That's a bit of a commitment, isn't it?
We have regionals at the end of the month. She'd already actually be starting too late.
Please, Mom, please.
This is really what you want?
Yes, more than anything.
Okay, I'll just have to figure out how to get you home. I'm reading tarot cards at the Lululemon. Well, not at it, but just near enough to get the foot traffic.
I'm so sorry to interrupt. I'm Lurline. I'm Fendi's mom from Five Alive.
I'm Allison. This is Kimberly.
Oh, her I know. My goodness. Aren't you a beautiful dancer? Isn't she just a beautiful dancer, Fendi?
Yeah, I guess so.
Don't mind her. She's just not used to anyone being better than her. Oh, I heard y'all talking about rides, and I just wanted to see if I can help. I'm a full-time homemaker. I don't have to work because my husband, Lee, is a bigwig in the local pool industry. We don't like to brag. But anyway, if it's a problem getting Kimberly back and forth, I could easily give her a ride. There's room in my Mercedes.
That's really nice of you, but I'll figure something out.
Oh, honey, here at MorningStar, we're a family. You let us help you.
Honestly, it is no trouble. I'm very wealthy, so I have the time. And it'll be a great chance for the girls to get to know each other, you know, figure out each other's foibles and spot each other's weaknesses. I know Fendi would just love that, wouldn't you, Fendi?
Yes, Mama. It'll be nice to make a new friend.
Okay, what do you say, Kimber?
Sure, thank you.
Oh, well, it's all set then. And don't think we're forgetting about you, Mama. All us mamas get together for pizza and wine at my house every Wednesday. I'm very generous because I can be. I'll text Belleth for your number.
Okay. Bye, Lurline. Bye, girl. Bye, Fendi, honey. Well, you've done very well, Miss Kimberly. You'll be a perfect addition to our team as soon as the check clears.
It should be good by tomorrow.
Let's hope. Okay, have a good night, y'all.
Wow, you must like this. You're actually smiling.
No, I'm not, shut up.
There's my girl. Let's get home to watch TV in separate rooms, like a family.
Allison gets in the car and drives away as Belleth walks back to the studio. Interior Morningstar studio. Toby is sweeping the floor as Mr. Jeremy continues to dance in the mirror. Belleth walks in and he stops.
You have done very well, Belleth.
Thank you, Master. I thought she might please you.
Oh, you thought right. Now that we are whole again, we can begin our plan for regionals.
Yes, Master. And for your dinner, Master, I was thinking Chick-fil-A.
Ooh, you know me too well, Belleth. It's the only place that shares my love of bigotry and saturated fats. Extra pickles, please, honey.
Mr. Jeremy picks up his towel and starts to leave the room.
Toby.
As soon as the boy's name is called, he freezes and his eyes grow pale.
Yes, Master.
You will finish your sweeping and turn out the lights. Then you will return to your post for the night. Is that understood?
Yes, Master.
Good. Now remember, no one in, no one out.
Mr. Jeremy leaves the room. Toby finishes sweeping in one move and goes to turn out the light.
Not Gemma.
Toby turns out the light. As soon as he does, Gemma appears ghostly and demented from within the mirror. Exterior, Lurleen's house. Allison walks up to the walkway of a perfect McMansion. Solar lights, topiaries, tacky and predictable.
Mom, please don't embarrass me. I'm trying to make friends here.
So am I. Luckily, I have wine to help me out. Remember, you're getting us an Uber home. Uber.
Kimberly rings the bell and Lurleen appears right on cue.
There you are. Oh my God, and you brought a covered dish? Are you sure you're not Southern? Y'all get on in here.
Exterior, interior Lurleen's house. The backdrop of any Real Housewives episode. A sea of tasteless beige.
Oh, y'all, they're here. And they brought,
vegan brownies.
Allison hands a covered dish to Lurleen.
Oh, they feel real dense. Honey, Cindy's up in her room with Ramada. I know they're waiting for you. Oh, the fourth room on the right, past the second bathroom and the gym. We're a Nordic track family. Always have been, always will be. How about we get you some wine, Mama?
Interior Lurleen's kitchen. More beige. Sitting on the kitchen island, Patty Beth is pouring Allison a huge glass of wine.
Now, this is my best friend in the whole wide world, Patty Beth Scruggs.
I'm Ramada's mama, the angry looking one.
Nope, I think that's my daughter.
Hey, you are so funny. I mean, isn't she funny? Like, funny.
Your daughter's named Ramada?
Yeah, named her for where I made her. That's why I done it for all my kids. Ramada, Corolla, Petco, Church, and this little one on the way is Wendy. I thought that was better than toilet and still accurate.
If it's a boy, you could call him John.
Patty Beth, I think we have ourselves a live wire here.
Really? You got any Coke?
No. Should you even be drinking?
Jeez, way to bring me down. You know, your daughter's real talented. I think my Ramada's just a little jealous.
Andy's not. That would be admitting something I don't think she's ready to yet. Kimberly must have been the star of her last studio. Where'd y'all come from?
Ohio. It's sort of like the South.
All of the racism, none of the charm. My ex lives in Cincinnati.
In a prison.
So Ohio.
Funny! I like that. God, I love to laugh. So how long has Kimberly been dancing? She's so advanced.
That is the crazy part. Kimberly's never really danced before.
That's not crazy. That's insane.
I was sort of shocked she made it past the audition. I've barely seen her move for like 3 years.
Wow. And what do you do, honey, besides showing up with a daughter who's obviously a ringer?
Well, I'm kind of a spiritual worker.
Oh, like a psychic? Wait, can you see ghosts and shit? Is there anyone around me now? Is it my Uncle Earl? Tell him to back it on up. People rules are still ghost rules.
The doorbell rings.
I'll be right back. Do me next.
I really just think of myself as someone who works with energies, you know?
So do you see ghosts or not?
Fudgy enters, pushing her mother, Miss Patsy, 90s, a very old, very possessed woman. A husk in makeup, Michaela follows after her.
Sorry I'm late, y'all. Mama's sitter canceled, so I had to drag her along. Michaela, Peanut, say hello.
I'm Michaela.
Kill me. She's trying to kill me.
Oh, honey, I wouldn't have to try too hard. Is there a wall somewhere I can park her? She won't be no trouble. She knows what's good for her.
What?
Out in the hall near the downstairs WC. That's French for shitter. Oh, we were just finding out that Allison here is a psychic.
No, I'm not, really.
Michaela Peanut, now run up them stairs with the girls while I put Granny away. Go, run up.
Michaela goes and then stops.
The way the stairs go, honey. Fingers crossed she makes it this time. So, you're a psychic. Oh, well, that sounds like devil worship to me.
Oh, don't listen to her. She's a Jesus nut. How many times you been baptized now, Fudgy?
Oh, 28. I started going just because the pool, but after the 12th time, I really start to believe.
I'm not really a psychic. I help people find their blocks, and I help to get them unblocked.
So like an enema?
Sure, but for your soul.
All right.
Okay.
Kill the devil.
All three ladies nod. All right. Interior Fendi's room. Ramada comes in, dragging Michaela. Fendi is sitting on the bed with Kimberly.
You almost made it, Michaela. You're getting so much better.
But if you keep helping her, she is not going to learn on her own.
Well, excuse me for wanting to look after my teammate, Fendi.
Oh, why? Is that something a captain does?
It's something a real captain does. No wonder you don't know anything about it. Always worrying about your hair and pumping up those little gumdrops you call titties.
Well, if you don't like my gumdrops, why are you looking at them all the time?
Come on, guys. Can't we just chill?
You chill, Hot Topic. Nobody asked you.
These clothes are vintage.
Oh, they look black to me. I'm Michaela.
Michaela, we've met earlier today.
In the black time?
You think you're going to be Jeremy's pick for captain. Why? Because you're the prettiest.
You think I'm pretty?
Fendi, you can't be captain. You can't even do a split.
Yes, I can. Watch me.
Fendi goes into a split.
You see me? Are you watching me?
Oh, look who's down here with you.
Ramada splits and starts rubbing herself on the floor.
Oh, look at me. I'm Fendi, and everything comes easy to me because I'm pretty and rich, and my daddy builds pools.
Oh, what was that? Oh, I'm Ramada, and I'm over here being wild and strong and untamable and somehow soft.
They are flirting with each other, and they are very into the role reversal.
Should we be watching this?
Sleepovers get real weird around here. I'm
Kayla. Kayla, I know.
Interior Lurleen's kitchen. The ladies all enjoy a glass of wine.
No, me and Mama got displaced by Katrina. Not the hurricane, my sister. We've been here about 7-8 years. But these two girls, they've been friends for, oh God, how long is? I'm so drunk, my wig's coming off.
Oh, honey.
Oh, that's
you. No, we've been me and Lorelene from kindergarten on up. Me and Lorelene been friends all our lives, right, girl?
That is right, girl. And you know what? I would not have it any other way. We've done everything together. Girl Scouts, cheerleading. Oh, we went even after the same boy.
Right, but you got him.
Yes, I did.
The door opens. Lee Melandro, 30s, ruggedly handsome, the high school quarterback who still hasn't lost it. He's carrying the pizzas.
Well, speak of the devil. Lee, honey, I want you to meet our new mommy in the group. This is Allison. Her daughter's Kimberly, I was telling you about.
Oh, I've been hearing about you all day. Well, nice to meet you. Welcome to the cult.
Oh, go on, you. Will you call the girls down for pizza?
Oh, I'll just run one on up. Give the ladies all the space they need. Plus, I don't want little Michaela getting stuck on them stars again.
Lee smiles, grabs the box of pizza, and goes upstairs.
Liz, Lurleen, I don't know how you managed to keep that fine man all to yourself. God, I could just gobble him up!
Oh, fudgy, honey, don't.
So, you and Lee dated, but then Lurleen married him. How did that work?
Well, Lee and I met at a party, but I ended up getting too drunk that night, and...
And she ended up under Eddie Scruggs.
Yeah. I have my first daughter, Mazda. She lives in Tucson. It's sad.
Listen, y'all, listen, I gotta make a point. I never would have made a move if they were actually dating. I mean, what sort of a friend would that make me, huh? Oh, life took quite a spill for my Patty Beth after little Mazda. Kicked off the cheerleading squad, dropped out of high school. But I stood by her then, and I stand by her now.
Y'all are gonna make me cry.
I'm gonna go use that French shitter.
Oh, that's my girl. Oh, Lord, she could have done anything. And now she's just trash. I mean, I love her, but she's trash.
Oh yeah, trash. And don't never share a straw with her.
Mm. Interior Fendi's room. Lee brings in a pizza and gives it to the girls.
Okay, now y'all done make a mess. Hope you're being real nice to your new friend, Kimberly.
They are. Thank you, Mr. Melindro.
I'll talk to him. He's my daddy. Just because you didn't have one.
Fendi, now that is not nice. You apologize to Kimberly.
I'm sorry.
Now, y'all behave. Hey, right? Okay, I'm heading into my gym now, all right?
Hey, my daddy's in a hole under our house, but I'm not supposed to tell anybody.
Does anybody want the cheese from my pizza?
You don't eat the cheese?
No, I'm trying to be captain, aren't you?
Kimberly spits out the pizza and gets up.
I think I need to go to the bathroom.
Well, the one for the guests is downstairs.
Oh, be careful. Stairs is evil.
Interior hallway. Patty Beth is walking by as Kimberly passes her in a hurry.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You all right there?
Yes, I just need to use the bathroom.
Kimberly rushes down the stairs.
Psst, Beth, psst.
No.
Come on, baby, I've been missing you.
And whose fault is that?
The summer is a pool man's Christmas. You ought to know that by now.
You know, it's always something with you. And after 20 years, I still ain't got nothing.
That ain't true, you got me.
Whenever you can sneak off.
And I'm good to them kids, ain't I? You don't want for nothing, do you?
Lee, I'm living in a trailer with 5 kids and 1 on the goddamn way. I ain't got 1 shirt that don't have Garfield on it. You say you love me, but I ain't got nothing to show for it but a bunch of kids that don't even know that they's yours.
I know, and I'm sorry. I'd give you more, but you know how Lurleen watches every penny.
Well, then leave her.
You know that ain't possible. Now, I love you, Patty Beth. I need you.
I need to get on back. They'll be wondering where I am.
Well, God, at least touch it a little. Yeah, I'll finish myself off, I swear.
Liar. Get on in there, but be quick.
They both go into the gym. Interior Lurleen's kitchen. Allison is having a piece of pizza with Fudgy and Lurleen.
And it wasn't so much that we had grown apart. It was that we found out we didn't really like each other.
Oh, I understand. I had a very serious relationship with a man in Nigeria, and when I did not send him his money on time...
Ding dong, ding dong.
Now, who could that be?
Interior gym. Patty Beth and Lee are having sex.
Did you hear something?
I think that's just the exercise ball. You want to move on to that bench?
Come on, now, you need to finish, Lee. They'll be missing me downstairs.
Well, help me, woman.
Oh, Christ. 47 red, 52 blue, right up the middle. Hey,
Pop goes a weasel.
We're going to have to talk about what that's all about one day, you know.
Interior, Lurleen's kitchen. Lurleen enters with Becky following behind her.
Becky, what are you doing here?
It's Wednesday, isn't it? We always come to Lurleen's on Wednesdays. She's so generous because she can be.
Okay. Allison, this is Becky Lockery.
We met at the grocery store. Have you heard anything about your daughter?
Lurleen and Fudgy freeze.
No, thank you for asking. You're probably the only one around here that gives a damn.
What I miss? Oh, shit.
What, Patty Beth, what? Ain't I supposed to come around no more? Out of sight, out of mind, that it? You just gonna forget about me? Like you forgot about my Gemma.
Okay, nobody's forgotten Gemma, but it has been weeks.
1 week, just one.
Really? Seems like longer.
Becky, you know how friendly Gemma was. I think she probably just ran off with some guy.
Wait, was Gemma the reason there was a spot open in the Five Alive?
You took my Gemma's spot?
Now, Becky, honey, you need to stay calm. You've had a lot to drink. I'm just guessing.
No, I think that's just her hair. Becky, you should head on home, honey, okay? This is a mama's night.
And I ain't a mama no more?
Well, technically, no.
You all is false friends. All you smiling to my face, telling me and Gemma we was family. Well, where's my family now? Lurleen, you loved my Gemma. I know you did.
Sure I did. We all did. But she's gone now. Okay, honey, the group is called Five Alive for a reason.
Fudgy, could you move on if something happened to Michaela?
I'm actually much more prepared for that than you might think.
Patty Beth, back me the fuck up here. Come on, please.
I'm sorry, Becky. I don't think there's nothing that we can do.
I can't believe what I'm hearing. This woman's daughter is missing. Someone's taken her. 11-year-olds just don't disappear.
Wouldn't it be easier if they did, you hussy?
I'm on your side here.
No, you ain't. None of you is. You was just acting all nice to me so you could weasel that worthless daughter of yours into my Gemma spot.
Don't talk about my daughter like that.
Okay.
Exterior guest bathroom. Kimberly comes out of the bathroom wiping her hands. She hears her name being mentioned and she stops to listen. Miss Patsy is sitting in her wheelchair near the door, passed out.
My daughter earned her spot fair and square.
Well, that's up for a little debate.
Oh, Lurleen, we're not saying that out loud.
You don't think it's a little suspicious? A girl who has never danced before comes in and gets Gemma's spot like that?
It's just natural talent.
Get out. Get out! Get out! Get out!
Mama, you get off her!
Get out!
Lord, why won't this old woman die?
No!
Are you all right?
Oh, honey, she didn't get you too bad. She ain't got her teeth in, do she?
I want to go home.
I think it's time anyway. Listen, thank you for the pizza. It's been nice to get to know you.
Every Wednesday, come rain or come shine, you're part of Five Alive now.
Allison takes Kimberly to the car.
Well, I'd still like a glass of wine. Well, fuck you every much too.
Exterior MorningStar parking lot. Allison, the next day, Allison pulls in with Kimberly.
Aren't you coming in with me?
No, I have to go and catch the after Weight Watchers crowd. They're real angry and looking for answers. Kim, you sure this dancing thing is really what you want?
Yes, why do you keep asking me that?
I don't know. It's just all sorts of new.
Well, new town, new us, right?
Right. I'll pick you up after practice.
Kimberly gets out and goes into the studio. Allison sits in the car, staring. John knocks on the window and scares the shit out of Allison.
The fuck?
Everything all right?
Oh, sorry. I was just in my head.
That looks like a good place to be. You dropping your daughter off for dance class?
Yep. It's all her new thing now, but I have to tell you, that place gives me the creeps. What do you know about the people who run it?
Lots, but I only gossip over dinner. It's my rule.
Listen, that's sweet, but I'm just getting out of a marriage. And
it's just dinner. Relax. If you really want to know about MorningStar and all the rest of Baffomette Parish, come on by.
I'll think about it.
Interior, MorningStar studio. Mr. Jeremy is beginning his class. All the girls sit on the floor cross-legged as their mothers sit in the back of the room, except Allison.
Now listen, I know what's on all y'all's minds. I can feel it. It's in the air. Do you smell that, girls, and also Toby? That's the smell of a new beginning.
Oh, I thought that was Kimberly's tights.
Fendi, honey, that's not nice.
Fendi, bitch is just too obvious for you. Pick another color, huh? Oh, what are you laughing at, Butch? Huh? If you had half that little toehead's grace, I'd be much better off. No, Michaela, put your hand down. Fendi does not actually have a toe for a head, and yes, I know who you are.
Well, I guess we're both real smart then.
Now, come on. We are a team again, y'all. The five alive. 5 points of a beautiful star. And I am thrilled to announce that the fifth point on our star, our newest dance captain for this year's regionals, is... Kimberly, get your butt on up there.
Mr. Jeremy starts to clap, but no one joins in. Beleth tries to beef up the class, but everyone is only half-hearted.
Oh, I am disappointed in y'all. I thought this was a team. Oh, that don't sound like a team to me.
I'll tell you what y'all are. Y'all are bitter little Bettys. Because why? Y'all wanted to be captain. Is that it? Is that what's happening? Fendi, why are you making a face like an old asshole?
Mama, he can't say that to me.
Then don't make that face.
You thought it was going to be you, didn't you? Didn't you, Ramada?
Well, why the hell not?
Ramada, honey, it's why the fuck not.
You've seen your chooches and your chews. Your dingle dangles are a mess. And don't even get me started about your bubble bums. Oh yeah. You know you're not up to par yet, Ramada. Maybe you just don't want it hard enough.
I don't. I hate me.
Well then, change. Kimberly came in here and you saw what she did. You saw it, didn't you?
Yes.
You know what I mean? Like good dizzy.
Okay, I don't even know why I'm justifying myself to y'all. You see the name on that studio there? It says Studio A, and that stands for Mr. Jeremy A. Tans, and that's me. You come in here, you play by my rules. Do I make myself clear?
Yes.
Now move back. Toby, get up here. Now, since I can always count on Toby here.
Always, master.
All right. Well, there's people around, so maybe act like a person, okay? Now, Toby is going to show you what I've been working on for regionals. Y'all ready?
Yes.
Are you? Because I don't hear you.
Yes.
All right, good. Bella, hit the pipe.
Toby starts to dance.
Oh,
regional folks ain't gonna know what hit them.
All right. All right now, everybody up on your feet. Let's learn, y'all. Now it starts on our star spots.
The girls and Toby form the 5 points of a pentagram.
Excellent. Now, left hand, look at this shiny corridor. And oh, now it's in the right. Just that. Now, 5, 6, 7, 8. Look at this shiny corridor.
And now, interior, Allison's car. Kimberly is sitting in the front seat telling Allison all about being captain.
And then Mr. Jeremy said I was a natural. I was picking up the routine almost from the beginning.
But he still thinks you need the extra sessions.
Yes, Mom. Mr. Jeremy always needs extra sessions with his captains.
Well, that's great. And you're making friends, aren't you?
Yeah, I guess.
Interior Lurleen's car. Lurleen is pissed. Fendi is pouting.
I mean, who the fuck does she think he is? That little $3 queer? You're the one with the star power. You're the one should have been captain.
I know, Mama, you said.
Well, you should have said. Ain't I always taught you to stand up for yourself, huh? Sitting there making some cheap joke about tights when you should have been beating that little bitch's ass.
Mama, it's not a big deal. Mama, why are you stopping the car?
I can't believe what I just heard. Fendi Swatch and Millendro. Did I just hear you say it's not a big deal?
I'm sorry, Mama.
Gonna be. You keep shit talking like that. Because that, honey, that's shit talk, Fendi. And I won't never hear no shit talk from no child of mine. You understand me? Okay, listen. In this world, you got to take what you want. No matter who you got to hurt. You know, whose life you got to destroy. All right? You think we'd be living where we was if I didn't know that firsthand?
But that all comes from Daddy.
And who got him first, huh? You're mine, girl. And mine don't settle for nothing but the best. You heard me?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Now, just got to figure out how to take back what's ours. All right. Get me my phone. Find my steering wheel.
Interior, Patty Beth's car. Ramada is pouting as Patty Beth is talking on the phone to Lee.
Well, yes. I guess the exhaust fan in my room is broken again, Lee. Did you want to come over and fix it?
You're not supposed to be on the phone when you're driving, Mama.
What? No, not you. Not, hold on, I got another call. Oh, speak of the devil. She's on the other line. No, I'm not going to answer it. Unlike you, I'm not at her beck and call. That is fair, Lee. Your little girl is broken here. And where are you? Exactly. Now I'm going to go get cigarettes. Ramada, honey. Now, I know you're disappointed, but there's always next year.
And then we get there and nothing happens either. I'm just not good enough.
Ramada, honey, that ain't true.
It is. And that's all I deserve. I'm always getting what's left over. I got half of Mazda's clothes. I share my room with Petco and soon Wendy. I don't even have a real daddy.
Well, what about Uncle Lee?
He's not my real daddy. I don't deserve nothing just for me.
Now, you stop that right there. You didn't get to be captain, all right? That's one thing, but that ain't all. You're down now, but this is the time to figure out how you're gonna get the rest. Just when they're counting you out, you figure out a way to get back in that game. Now, when I got pregnant with Mazda, you know what I was thinking?
What?
I need to get out of your meemaw's house and start making some money. So you know what I did? I signed me up for manicure and arts at the beauty college, and that's where I went every single day. Got my license, got a job, moved on out, and I have my beautiful baby girl. Now, looking back, maybe it was a bad idea to be around all them fumes.
Is that why Mazda's face is like that?
That is one of several theories. What I'm saying to you is, honey, you want something in this world. You gotta go get it. You may not get it how you planned or even how you wanted, but that don't mean you still can't have it. You plan for it. And when you're least expecting it, you go on up and you take what should have been yours all along. You hear me, Ramada?
Yes, Mama, I do.
Good. Now your Uncle Lee's coming over to fix the exhaust fan in my room.
That fan breaks a lot.
Well, after 20 years, you'd think I'd get a new one.
Interior, Fudgy's car. Fudgy drives with Michaela in the front seat.
Michaela, Peanut, everything all right? You're not sad about not being captain, are you?
No, I was just burping in my mouth.
That's my girl.
Exterior, Allison's house. Allison gets out of the car and Kimberly follows with her dance bag.
I mean, I guess they like me. Michaela does, at least.
She's the dumb one, right?
Yes, Mom. I wish you would take my dancing seriously. It's everything to me now. It's my whole life. Why do you have to be so selfish?
Oh, earning money to feed and clothe you. Yes, I am a monster.
Why do you have to use my words against me? And why won't you watch me like the other moms?
Because I have to work. And that place smells like a grease fire in a horse restaurant. How do you not smell that?
I'm the only one there whose mom doesn't watch. Well, except for Toby, but he's an orphan, so that doesn't count. Please, Mommy, I need you.
Mommy? Wow, you are pulling out all the stops. Next, you'll offer to take out the garbage or clean your room.
Okay, don't shake me down. Are you going to watch me or not?
Interior MorningStar studio the next morning. Allison finds a seat in the back as all the other mothers sit down and settle in. Toby is sitting on the floor, frighteningly still. Allison is a little unnerved.
So you live here? That must be neat. Or not? I'm sort of at a loss here. I don't blink twice for no. I don't know.
Oh, our Toby don't talk much. And when he do, it's mostly just gobbledygook. We're so excited you're going to be joining us today.
I hope it's all right. I promise I won't vomit this time.
Oh, that's all right, honey. Sometimes people are they're just bowled over by Mr. Jeremy's talents. He is quite something.
Sure. But what?
Fendi comes into the room, followed by Lurleen, who is carrying Allison's plate, now filled with new brownies.
Well, look who's joining us all on the bench. You know, I was going to bring your plate to little Kimber, but now I can just give it right to the lady herself, Lucky.
Lurleen hands Allison her plate, piled high with brownies.
And you made brownies. You didn't have to do that.
Oh, you know I did. I'd never return an empty plate. What would my mama think of me? We enjoyed yours so much. So many nuts and twigs.
Daddy used them to fix the shed.
Fendi, go and stretch.
Fendi goes and joins the other girls. Belleth tries to move towards the brownies.
Oh, don't they look good? Do you mind if I...
No! I mean, I made them special for Allison here, and I think she and our little Kimber deserve them, don't you?
It's okay. I probably can't eat them anyway. I'm a vegan.
Oh, I just use condensed milk. I don't think that counts.
Oh, you know what? Maybe it's better if I don't. I'm trying to fit into some real sweet slacks for regionals next week.
Patty Beth enters with Ramada.
Oh, Patty Beth, look who's joining us on the bench today.
Oh, hey, Allison. Hey, any of y'all know how to get a boot off a car? I drove with it here, but it ain't going to get me home.
Oh, Patty Beth, you and your funny, poor ways.
Don't worry about the bench at all. It's mostly just us bitching and Fudgy brings spat snacks. Oh, speaking of.
Don't. I made them special for Allison.
Now, I take it y'all got my email this morning about the costume changes, right? Now, Mr. Jeremy believes the green will make us all look sickly, and the black will be better for Kimberly's complexion.
Oh, well, you don't have to change it for her.
Mr. Jeremy and sis.
Well, that's just fucking great. Now I gotta start again. What does he think we're doing here? Shit. One more change and I'll be going down to Bernice at Hobby Lobby just to get some, I'll be going down on Bernice at Hobby Lobby just to get some fringe.
Wow. Okay, Patty Beth. Dirty. Well, dreams are expensive and you knew that when you signed up for Five Alive, miss.
Yeah. Well, so's neoprene, Bella. Why you always got to defend him?
Mr. Jeremy is a genius.
He's also a pain in my fucking ass.
Patty Beth, You need to calm down and you need to think about what you're saying.
I have thought, and I am not the only one. And don't you never tell me to calm down. I mean, seriously, we pay for the lessons and the coaching and the flippers.
False teeth.
Yeah. Why not cover up my poor Ramada's fucked up baby teeth to make her feel even more self-conscious about them? The whole thing's a fucking joke.
Are my teeth really fucked up?
Yeah, but in a hot way.
And then the taps and the boas and the top hats and the canes. I mean, it just fucking adds up, don't it? And for what? So that little girl can dance?
Well, it's starting to sound to me like you don't want Ramada to dance. Like you don't want her to be part of Five Alive. Huh?
Mama?
I ain't saying that. You're not listening to me.
But I am.
They all turn and Mr. Jeremy stands in the doorway.
Oh, the smell's coming from him. It's different.
I've been listening to this the whole time. And do you know what I hear? I hear loser talk.
I can't. It's too much. I'm a single mama and I was a pregnant teen. I let all my chances go by because I couldn't keep my legs together in high school.
And I bet that's someone else's fault too, isn't it, Patty Beth?
Oh, Mr. Jeremy, please. She didn't mean it.
Oh, I think she did. I think she wanted to make a big old dealy deal about it right here in front of y'all. She wanted to take me down. But you see, honey, you're not doing nothing to me. You're just proving what you are. You speak loser because you've been living loser since that pleated skirt went up and you had to drop out. You've been living loser so long, you don't know no better now. Might be all you'll ever know.
Get your shit, Ramada. We're leaving.
No, the girl stays.
You don't get to tell me nothing about my daughter.
Even you can't be so selfish to want her to have the same loser's life as you. Or can you?
Oh, I think I'm gonna throw up.
Fudgy enters with Michaela.
Sorry, y'all. Oh, I didn't even have time to stop and pick up nothing. Mama finally died, and I've been burning her things all morning.
All right, silence, fat one. So what's it gonna be, Patty Beth? You gonna apologize for this little show, or will you finally have the courage to do the strong thing and walk away?
Come on, Ramada, honey.
Ramada, don't. Please.
Cindy, honey, stay out of it, okay? This is a poor person thing that your Auntie Patty Beth's got to do, okay? Remember when we watched them people on Springer?
No, fuck you, Lorleen. You're just as bad as him. Y'all think this is the biggest fucking deal in the world? Well, guess what? It ain't. It's fucking kids dancing, all right? It's kids dancing. Now, Ramada, let's go.
I'm staying here. I don't want to be a loser, Mama.
A loser like me? Is that it?
The child wishes to stay. I think you should respect her wishes.
Fuck y'all. Seriously. Fuck you. Fuck all. Fuck everybody. Get everybody to go fuck yourself.
Oh.
Fudgy sits down and has a brownie.
These brownies are amazing. Who made these?
Fudgy, don't!
Fudgy starts to choke and seizes. Exterior parking lot. John is comforting Allison, who has been actually seriously ill.
Listen, you'd have a better case against going out with me if maybe you'd stop showing up in my work all the time.
You just don't give up, do you?
No. I mean, within reason, I'm still very into consent.
Glad to hear it. I'm new here, and I'm really not looking for a big commitment.
Dinner's not that big of a commitment. I have to run back. I have 6 tables and not a vindaloo in sight.
Patty Beth comes storming out of the studio.
Oh, Patty Beth, what's wrong?
I've had a fuck enough. Oh, and it looks like you have too. Y'all right?
Don't you smell the burning smell in there?
Burning through my money. Sure as shit I do. I'm going. And you got any sense, you'll get your kid and you get going too. Yeah, meet me in our spot.
Patty Beth gets in her car and drives off. Suddenly, an ambulance pulls into the parking lot. Lorleen comes running out of the dance studio.
Oh, hurry up. Oh, dear God. She's not breathing. She's not breathing.
Patty, Beth, and Allison rush towards the dance studio. End of act one. Intermission. Take it away, Justin and Luis.
Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for tuning in. That is a riot. Oh my goodness. I've seen this three times through with rehearsals and whatnot. Did you see the cone? I could not. I was not ready for that cone. I want to remind everybody that before we get into this Q&A with Justin, that we are collecting donations, a $20 suggested donation. Give what you can, because we will be donating a percent of it to bail funds throughout the country. For example, we have the Bail Project, the National Bailout, the Brooklyn Community Bail Fund, and we're donating through a page on ActBlue that will then disperse all of our donations, which we're hoping is quite a bit. We need it nowadays. Oh, Justin, you're here. I was gonna introduce you.
I am.
No introduction needed. This is the one, the only, Justin Sayre. I always feel like I pronounce your name wrong, your last name wrong. Sayre, right?
Sayre, yeah.
Sayre. Okay, wonderful. I won't make that mistake again. Okay, so we have a couple questions.
Sure.
We have a very chatty group watching. I love that. I love reading all of the comments. They are cackling. They're definitely telling us. That's great. I love it. Okay, so let's get down to the first question. We only have 5 minutes. So, first off, I love this wig.
Thank you so much.
You just create characters for yourself in your plays just to wear fun wigs.
It's real. My whole career is about costume changes. So
I love that.
Yeah, essentially.
I love that. You know, I love drag. If anybody knows me, you know love drag. So, okay. But just to add on to that, do you go into writing plays knowing you're going to be in the show, or do you write a character and then fall in love with it that you're like, I have to do this? What's that process?
Well, the nice thing about these plays in particular is that we've kind of been forming this little company. So it's, mm-hmm. I automatically think of, you know, oh, here I can plug people in and, you know, we have such a gifted group. I mean, it's really just a powerhouse. So it's really kind of thinking about not only what I would love to see them do, but also what I think they would enjoy doing. And then I usually kind of just think of like, oh, what would be funny and something fun for me to do, you know? So I don't really go in with a plan, but I kind of, it all comes together sooner or later.
Did something attract you to Fudgy specifically? Did you know going in you were going to be playing this character?
I did know I was going to be playing Fudgy. I did know I was going to play. I don't know. I kind of thought she was just kind of the pudgy mom. And I feel like the pudgy mom of our little group. So
I love that. I want a Fudgy in my life. I would love to have baked goods every chance I get.
Do it, girl. Do it. I'm here.
Okay, so there's a lot going on in your plays that we've been doing for the past couple months, and they are hilarious, and they're camp, and they're very fun. When was the first time you were introduced to camp, and why are you so attracted to camp?
Well, I think it's a really, I think of it as a gay art form. I have thought of it that way, a way to kind of change things, change the way we view things that are sold to us as right. It's a way to kind of look askance from things. And I think I was introduced to camp probably as a very young person looking at old movies, a lot of campy old movies, anti-mame. But then when I really started to get into it, I was probably, I don't know, I think some, when I saw my first John Waters movie, that kind of changed the whole world. I think Female Trouble is still, I still watch it probably once a month just to kind
of. I just watched Divine's documentary recently, and that's the pinnacle of camp. It's amazing.
Everything,
wonderful.
Everything.
So we don't have much time left, and you actually covered all my questions in those two answers.
Oh, all right.
No, that's wonderful. Great. I love it. I love it.
So happy. So
let's tell these beautiful people at home what's next for Sweet Nell Productions.
So we're going to do. We're going to keep doing these plays once a month. Our next play is a kind of a send up a new play centered on Reversal of Fortune, the Sonny Bambulo story.
Oh my goodness. I have never heard.
It's called When Sunny Gets Blue, When Sunny Went Blue. And then for August, I think we're planning on doing a kind of Salem witch trial, something called Pittsfield, Massachusetts.
I didn't even know that. This is news to me. This is very
all new. Yeah.
This half of this is honestly educational for me, at least. I don't know who else. I mean, we all know, we know the birds that we did.
Sure.
But anything after the birds, I have no idea.
It's going to be a wonderful world.
I cannot wait. Okay, so we're being told places.
All right.
It's going crazy back.
Thank you so much. Make sure you contribute to Venmo, Sweet Nail Productions. Yeah, we're going to make that donation. Sweet Thanks, everyone. We'll see you at the end of the show. Thanks, y'all. Thanks, Louise.
No, my pleasure. Have a wonderful one. And I'm sorry you're dead, Fudgy.
Act 2. Interior Morningstar hallway later. Lurleen is absolutely distraught. Michaela stands by the gurney with her mother in a body bag.
She's dead. How could she be dead? I mean, she was alive 1 minute, and then something happened, and then I guess she was just dead. Fendi, are you there?
Yeah, Mama. She was eating one of your brownies.
Okay, listen, honey. Mama's thinking, okay? No need to remind me of facts that aren't helpful, okay? Go outside and sit with Kimberly's mama.
But Mama, we hate her, remember?
Fendi, don't make me lose my damn mind, okay? Get.
Lurleen, calm down. You want? I got some real generic fake Xanax in my pocketbook.
Oh, God. What is going to happen now?
With Michaela? I don't know, she seems fine.
Somebody put Mama in a baggie like they do Skeeter's doo-doo.
Well, here's hoping Skeeter's a dog of some kind. Honey, Lurleen, I know you're upset, honey, but...
Listen, I'm not talking about that little idiot. I'm talking about me, okay? What's gonna happen to me?
Bella? You'll need it in the office, your little pet.
Oh, shit. And she had some stew today. God damn it, I better go get me my gloves.
Poor Fudgy, so tragic. And all because there were a few peanuts in them brownies.
Oh, there weren't.
Oh, there weren't? I thought I saw some, and that would explain things since Fudgy was so horribly allergic.
Was she? She was. Yeah.
I think she said something about it last year at the Christmas concert.
Yeah, I remember.
Sure, there are probably other witnesses. Michaela, wasn't your mama allergic to peanuts, honey? You remember?
Oh, no, I'm mama's peanut. Aren't I mama? I'm your peanut.
Fuck me, I'm going to jail.
Not if you're just listening to me. Fudgy was allergic to peanuts. You would have warned her, but by the time you saw her eating them, she was already nibbling on the third. But wasn't that always Fudgy's fat way? Always gorging herself without thinking. It's simply an unfortunate accident. If I were a policeman, that's all I'd need to hear.
Oh, we don't need to get them involved, do we?
Not if we keep our story straight. The peanut thing makes a lot more sense than you poisoning another mama over your daughter not getting to be captain.
Me? What? Poisoned?
You? Yes, did. I know everything, Lurleen. But I'm not playing nothing. I can make this all go away. I can make people forget. I'm on your side. I don't want you to go to jail.
I didn't do anything.
You don't even need to lie to me. I'm not ever judging you.
Well, no, honestly, yesterday you told me my sweater looked like a unicorn's tampon.
Well, you know, that's just clothes, and it did. Now, that's not real. I'm talking about people. I'm talking about souls, and I'm here to help you with both.
I didn't mean to hurt her.
Of course you didn't. So why should you be punished? I can make all this go away. All you have to do is ask.
Help me.
Of course I will. Michaela, honey, you get away from that body bag. Your mama's going to start spoiling.
Oh, God, who's going to tell this poor, ignorant child that her mama's dead?
What?
Oh, okay. Michaela, your mama went to live with the angels.
Oh, at church?
Sort of. You know what? Why don't you come over and have a sleepover in Fendi's room tonight?
Oh, I don't have no pull-ups.
Oh, Michaela, honey, you still can't keep your wee-wees in?
Oh, no, I can. I just also like to be warm, right?
Exterior MorningStar parking lot. Allison is standing around with Fendi, Ramada, Kimberly, and Michaela.
Ramada, baby, where's your mama?
She left me here.
Lurline, what's happened? Was it?
Oh, a fudgy. I didn't know she was allergic to peanuts.
Oh, God, so is Kimberly. Thank God I didn't take them home.
Yes, thank God a poor, sweet, dear, fat woman tending after her cobweb of a mother and a daughter as stupid as Footskin ate one instead and died instead of you. Do you hear yourself?
Lurline, I'm sorry.
I just lost my best friend.
Mama, is Miss Fudgy?
Yes, but stop making a face like a cold duck. Michaela doesn't know yet.
Why didn't anybody tell her?
Oh, you try. Honey, Michaela, baby, get away from that bag, okay? Your mama's dead.
What?
She's gone, honey. Gone on home to Jesus. She's dead, okay? Okay, once she was alive, and now, opposite of that, okay? She's dead. She's deceased, okay? Pushing daisies, taking a dirt nap, moved on to mulch, okay? She's gone.
Oh, well, then we should check home first. The address is just tattooed on my neck in case I get lost.
God, I hope there is a home that'll take that poor, sweet girl. Oh, I got to get these kids home. Fendi, we're going to have Michaela and Ramada over the house for a big old sleepover.
Oh, Kimberly should come too.
It's okay. I don't have to.
Yes, you do when you were sleeping next to me.
Is it all right, Lurline?
Of course. We always got room. You've seen my house.
Lurline piles all the girls into the car. Allison is alone in the parking lot with nothing to do. Interior MorningStar studio. Belleth locks the door and looks out, seeing Allison. Toby comes in with a plate of brownies.
Where shall I put these brownies, mistress?
In the office. I'll give them to that old bitch. What is she looking for?
She's interested in the waiter. It's obvious. No wonder you don't see it.
I've displeased you.
You don't know how to do much else these days, do you, Bella? The mayhem I like for sure. The murder's a delicious bonus. But it could have easily gone the other way and jeopardized my girls. None of this could work unless I have my five girls.
I am sorry, master.
You're lucky is what you are. But the thing about luck, Bella, is that it runs out. And so does my patience.
Mr. Jeremy grips Belleth into a powerful spell. Belleth writhes in pain.
Oh, master, you're hurting me.
Yeah, well, you're annoying me, Belleth. So nanner, right back at you. You remember what it was like before you summoned me, huh? You want to go back to that terrible time?
I don't, master, please.
You were gross, Belleth. Just another fat, old, unhappy spinster of a dance teacher in ponchos of many colors. Working for that old bitch, Miss Francine, taking all her abuse, her criticism.
I still hate her.
Oh, I know. I heard you talk about it all the time until you finally got the courage to summon me. You brought me here and I handled her and I made all your stupid little dreams come true.
Yes, master, you did. You did. Please, you're hurting me.
Mr. Jeremy releases her.
I think you just needed to be reminded of what kind of power you're dealing with. See that you don't forget it again, okay? We clear here?
Yes, 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 Mr. Jeremy.
Good. Keep them girls and their mamas in line just until regionals. After that, let hellfire rain. Now listen, I'm heading home. I gotta watch Hollywood. I just love seeing how Ryan's doing since we made his deal.
Mr. Jeremy opens a trapdoor to hell and walks down.
Toodles, noodles, wee!
Toby enters.
Miss Francine won't eat them.
Then you make her do it!
Belleth marches to the office. Interior Indian restaurant. Allison waits at the counter for John to seat her.
Table for one.
Sure, if it's not that much of a commitment. Sit anywhere.
It's not really busy in here, is it?
No, we're more of a lunch place. Plus, strip malls get real creepy after dark.
Exterior underpass later. Patty Beth is smoking on the hood of her car as headlights cascade across her face. The car stops and Lee gets out.
Sugar, what's wrong? Larlene told me about Fudgy.
Fudgy? What the hell happened to Fudgy?
She died, huh? She's real allergic to them peanuts.
No, she wasn't.
These Larlene's brownies, you can only imagine what I was walking into at home. I had to get out of there.
Yeah, you always got to get out of there. You just never stay gone.
Oh, honey, what's the matter?
Ramada thinks I'm a loser.
She's just a kid.
She's just right. I got a goddamn boot on my car because I can't pay my goddamn drawer full of parking tickets. I live in a goddamn trailer packed to the gills with kids that ain't got no daddy.
I got me. So do you. If you need money, Patty Beth, I got money.
It's not enough. It's never been enough. I can't live on half as good no more, Lee. I can't let my daughter think she can waste her life like I wasted mine.
You didn't waste nothing. You're my lady. You're my wife, where it counts.
No, I'm not. If I was, I'd be in that big old house and you wouldn't be under no underpass needing to get away from me. It's my fault. I've been taking so little for so long. I've learned to get by on it, but Ramada can't. I won't let her. I can't do this no more, Lee.
No, baby, wait. Don't do this. Don't leave me.
Then leave her. Leave her tonight. Come home with me now and don't never go back.
Daddy Beth, baby, I can't. Now you know what she's like. She'd kill me. She'd kill us both.
Just like she killed Fudgy.
What? What are you talking about?
Fudgy wasn't allergic to no peanuts. She bought that stuff by the pallet after she got that dog. And besides, Laureline made them for Allison. If anything, she was trying to kill him.
I mean, it makes sense. Laureline's pure evil. You only got to see her eat corn on the cob to know that's true. But murder? Shit, I don't know.
And we gotta go get them brownies.
What?
She made them. If there's poison in them and we can prove it, we can put her away, lock her up, and throw away the key so she can't trouble neither of us ever again.
Oh, it sounds like a nice dream.
It don't have to be. Ain't we survived, got by on so little for so long? This is our chance to have it all. Just us.
You think?
I do. But first you gotta get down to that dance school and find them brownies.
Are you talking crazy? Me breaking into some dance school? It just sounds gay.
It's not gay.
Well, not straight either. Man, this all sounds so plumb crazy.
Maybe it is. But don't we deserve a little crazy? We ain't had much.
I love you, Patty Beth.
I need to believe that. But we need them brownies.
All right, I'll do it. I'll go. Maybe we can pump one out in the hatchback for old time's sake first.
God, I wish I knew how to quit you.
They go back in Patty Beth's car and bone. Interior, Fendi's bedroom. Lurleen is at the door. All the girls are tucked in together. Fendi and Ramada in the bed. Kimberly and Michaela on the day bed.
Okay, now I know it's early, but y'all have regionals. And mama needs to drink, all right? So night-night.
Lurleen turns out the lights.
You sad about Miss Fudgy?
Yeah.
Oh, so that's why you're acting like a baby?
I'm not, Fendi. Shut up.
I'm sorry.
Fendi puts her hand out. Ramada takes it.
I'll get cold out here over the covers.
Fendi puts her hands under the covers.
Fendi. Don't.
Don't what? I wasn't doing nothing.
Yes, you were. And you know I do something back, and then you do something again, and...
Ooh, you make me sound like some kind of lesbo.
You are. So am I.
Well, you should sleep on the floor if you're going to be so gay about it.
gay about being gay? That makes a lot of sense, Fendi.
Michaela and Kimberly stay perfectly still, trying to pretend to be asleep.
Does it get much weirder than this?
Sleepies, do not talk.
Kimberly starts to open her eyes and Michaela rolls over and slaps her in the face.
Ow, Michaela!
I don't just want mindless sexual exploration, Fendi. I want you to be my girlfriend.
I am. I'm your friend and I'm a girl.
Not that way. You know what I mean.
I do. And I guess I want that too. Now, can I just put my hands underneath again?
You can put them anywhere you want.
The bed starts to rock.
Oh, this is the weirder part.
They both wait as Ramada and Fendi hardcore bang it out.
Hey, Kimberly?
Yeah?
What is dead?
What? Sorry, they're really distracting.
Oh no. Mama is dead? What is that?
Like sleeping, I guess. But you don't wake up anymore.
No more? Not ever?
Nope.
Mama is no more?
I'm sorry, Michaela.
Someone made her no more?
They don't know. I don't know.
I'm going to make them no more.
Fendi finishes and the room is still. Ramada farts.
Oh, Ramada, you little piggy.
What? I'm relaxed.
Michaela gets up from bed and goes to the bathroom.
You girls are just mean. My mama is dead.
Kimberly follows.
Well, don't leave me.
Interior Indian restaurant. Allison finishes up her dinner as John sits down with her finally.
Want to help me put the chairs up? Either that or I'm charging you for the non.
Please, I'm a single mother. I really had fun tonight.
See? Not too much commitment.
The look out the window as Beleth storms out to her car.
What is she still doing here? I don't get her at all.
What's to get? And she used to work for Miss Francine, and now she's
Miss Francine, for herself. Her dog? The one she keeps locked in the office?
No, her old boss was called Miss Francine, but she's dead. Yeah, she had a stroke about 2 years ago. They had her cremated. We sent a tray of samosas for the funeral.
You must see a lot around here.
Yep. I saw the lockery girl the night she disappeared, waiting right in that doorway. And then...
Then what?
Nothing. I told the police, but nothing ever came of it. Her, she started following fish? Crazy. I know, but still does happen.
Suddenly, another car pulls into the parking lot. Allison dunks in her booth.
Hey, you don't have to do that. A lunch crowd is also an extramarital affair crowd.
Allison rises and sees Lee getting out of the car and trying to get into the dance studio.
What the hell is Lurleen's husband doing here?
Want to go find out?
Exterior, back door of MorningStar. Lee looks into the dumpster but sees nothing.
Shit.
Allison and John hide. Lee approaches the door and looks around. He jimmies the door and opens it. Lee looks around and goes in. Allison moves to follow Lee, but John pauses. There's a sound of a struggle. Allison and John freeze. There's terrible screams.
Don't move. Don't move at all.
Toby emerges, covered in blood, a bloody foot in his hand. He looks around, almost feral, and goes back inside.
We need to get the fuck out of here.
Allison and John run away. Interior, Allison's car. Allison and John drive home, totally freaked out.
He ate him, and that little boy ate that man. What is wrong with that dance studio?
I don't know, but you can never go back there, and neither can Kimberly.
We won't. I am getting all these flashes, terrible images, a lot of routines to contemporary pop. It's all horrible.
Do you need to pull over? I can drive you home.
If you do... Will you stay with me? I don't want to be alone tonight.
You sure you're up for that?
I'm sure.
All right. Let's go home.
Interior, Lurleen's house. The next morning, Lurleen is face down on her kitchen island, passed out after a heavy night of drinking. There's a loud knocking at the door, which wakes her up.
God, oh, hold up. Jesus Christ. Oh God, why am I wet? Oh shit, yep, did that too. Hold on.
Mama, someone's at the door.
You think I don't hear that? Go back to bed.
It's the morning, ma'am, and Reginald's is today.
Reginald's is today. That's what you sound like. Exactly like that.
Lurleen opens the door.
Kimberly! Kimberly, come on, honey. We have to go.
Kimberly comes out to the stairs.
But Mama, I have to get to the studio. Today is regionals.
You are never going back to that terrible place. We are leaving. We're moving today.
But...
No,
I don't care what any of you have to say about regionals. Don't keep saying regionals like it's a thing. This isn't Glee. Someone has died.
But even Michaela's going to regionals today. We can't be the five alive without five.
That is not my problem, Kimberly.
Kimberly moves to the stairs. Michaela stops her.
Don't! Stairs is evil.
Kimberly stops.
I'm not going.
Kimberly, this is not the time, all right? I get it. You want to be a moody tween, but we have to go.
I'm sorry. Could y'all maybe have this tender moment outside and much quieter? Jesus Christ, my whole body smells like yeast.
I'm tired of just leaving when you want something to change, Mom. If I want something to get better, I need to stay here and make it better myself. I'm the captain, and I say we're going to regionals, and we're going to win.
Kimberly turns and goes back into the room with the other girls. Lurleen moves Allison towards the door.
Okay, listen, I'll keep her here. You know, this will settle down in a few days, and then she'll be home. I know it.
Lurleen closes the door on Allison.
Or she won't. Just get the fuck out of my house.
Interior, La Quinta. Belleth leads the group of girls to the registration desk for regionals.
Oh, hello. Good morning. Hi. Belleth Blue Chart with MorningStar Dance Academy and Modeling.
No. Not when you say it like that. MorningStar Dance Academy and Modeling! Remember, we're here to win!
A voice emerges.
Now that's a pronouncement if I've ever heard one.
You.
The crowds part to reveal Mr. Sean, 30s, a rival choreographer from another company.
You're looking good, Jeremy. Your early hundreds are really suiting you.
Sean, I'm surprised you could find your way here today. Did you write the address on the side of the glory hole so you'd remember? You know, the sucking side.
Bitch.
Slut.
I love you.
I know. Come along, girls. We gotta rehearse.
Mr. Jeremy moves away and the girls instinctively start to follow.
We're actually in 104. You know what? I'll just follow.
I see you, Mr. Jeremy. I see you and I admire you, you beautiful sequin bastard. Annette, get my character flats. I need to frub this on out.
Interior, Allison's car. Allison pulls into the parking lot of MorningStar with John in the passenger seat.
Well, thanks for dropping me off. I had a really great time.
You didn't. It was awful.
It was. It really, really was. I just thought since we had the banter...
I know. Me too. Do you always do that elbow thing?
Nope. Never once. I'm sorry again.
No, it's fine. It's just a bruise. I'm sorry to be so sweaty.
At least you got wet somewhere, right? Well, we can still be friends.
Yeah. No.
Yeah, I know. That's why I had you bring me to work. It's better if you don't know where I live. Goodbye, Allison.
Goodbye, John.
John gets out of the car and starts to pull away. She is suddenly stopped by a distraught Patty Beth.
Oh, Patty Beth, what the hell are you doing?
Honey, you gotta help me. I think he came here and now he's gone.
Who?
Lee, Laureline's husband.
Oh God, Patty Beth, I'm so sorry. It was so awful.
You saw him? Where is he?
He went in there.
Then that's where I'm going.
No, 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 Patty Beth, wait!
Allison runs after Patty Beth, exterior hallway, at the hotel. A half-asleep Lurleen sits near a bunch of groceries and bags outside the rehearsal room, still trying to recover from her hangover. Beleth enters from the dance studio.
Lurleen, honey, wake up. You're drooling.
Oh, I'm sorry, Beleth. How's it going in there?
Oh, he's working him hard, but what else is new? He's just too demanding on all of us, isn't he? Mr. Jeremy told me all about you joining the team.
What? That was only one time with Mary Ellen Tinker, and I didn't even like it.
Oh, not that. You know about accidentally killing Fudgy.
Oh, yeah.
Michaela comes to the door to get some water. She stops at the sound of her mother's name.
No, I swear it was an accident, Beleth. Fudgy was allergic to peanuts.
Oh, okay. All right, honey, whatever you need to tell yourself. Word of warning, though. Once that man gets a hold on you, there's no telling how far he will ask you to go.
Like anal?
Oh, honey, worse. You know what? Will you hold my wallet while I run to the bathroom? I need to lighten my load and get my head in the game.
All that out just to say you're shitting? Come on, Beleth.
Oh, Michaela, sweetie, you need something?
Mr. Jeremy told me to get some waters.
Lurleen pulls out a few bottles.
Oh, you're a good girl, Michaela. Your mama would be so proud of you today.
You must miss her something awful.
I do. Are you sad too?
Of course I am. Your mama was a good, good friend of mine.
Yep.
Michaela takes the waters and goes back to the room.
Oh, thank God for the stupid.
Oh, it's true. I'm going to go run up to the seafood dog, to the seafood bar. Do you want anything, like hair of the dog or something?
Honey, I got in my purse. Shit, Beleth. I've been drunk before.
Exterior back to door of MorningStar. Patty, Beth, and Allison come back around to the door.
And you saw him come back here?
Yes, and then there was a fight.
With who?
I don't know. I just saw Toby with a foot.
That could have been anyone's foot. You never know. He could be in there right now laughing, having a good old joke on us.
Patty Beth, is there something you're not telling me? Something about you and Lee?
Do you need me to actually say it?
Does Lurleen know?
No. I don't even think she's guessed. And Ramada looks just like him. Oh, I loved Lee Millendrell my whole life. And I've been more of a wife to him than Lurleen ever knows how to be. If something happened to him, I need to see it for myself.
Well, he went in there, but the door's locked. You don't know how to...
Oh, why? Because I'm trash and know how to illegally enter places? Because I do. Move.
Patty Beth jiggers the door open and it opens. Allison holds her hand.
I'm right here with you.
They walk in. Patty Beth screams.
Jesus Christ, Lee, baby, what is that doing?
Interior rehearsal studio at the hotel. Michaela, Fendi, Kimberly, Ramada, and Toby all lean over exhausted. Mr. Jeremy is not amused.
Y'all are pathetic. Y'all are pathetic. And you know what? Worst of all, I can't believe you made me come all this way to this beautiful La Quinta Inn just to embarrass me like this.
We're sorry, Mr. Jeremy. We're trying.
I'm not asking you to try. I'm asking you to do.
Don't talk to her like that.
What?
Babe, don't.
Oh, please. You two finally bumping Dixie cups? You disgust me. Everybody out.
They all get up and move toward the door.
Except for Kimberly. I expected better from you. You're my captain.
I'm sorry, Mr. Jeremy.
And let's start again from the beginning.
Kimberly starts to go to her spot and stops. She's in the wrong space.
Oh God, why am I so stupid?
I don't know. You weren't looking for a coddle there, were you? Because coddlers are for bottlers. Are you a baby sucking little baba?
No, I'm tired.
You keep telling me all the things you is, and I only see the one thing you ain't. Now again.
Kimberly tries to do the move again. She keeps repeating.
I need to know that you want this.
I do. Mr. Jeremy, can I stop, please? It's starting to hurt me.
Good. It should. Everything in this world has a price, and I guess I'm wondering, what is yours, huh? What would you need to be the greatest dancer in the world?
Well, I really wish my mom could be here today.
Oh, well, that ain't pathetic at all. But she made her choice, didn't she? She wanted to take you away from all this, but that's not what you wanted, is it?
No, I guess not.
You guess?
I know.
Rest. You look real red. I'd almost think we were related.
Kimber bends down to catch her breath.
If I knew how committed you were to this, I could make things happen for you, Kimberly. I tried to make that happen for Gemma. You heard about Gemma?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You remind me of her a little bit. Shay was a great dancer, just like you. Had the drive. Or at least I thought she did. I tried to build her up, telling her all the time how I wish she could be the girl I see in the mirror. But she didn't want it hard enough. Now, start again.
I'll try.
Give yourself to the music, Kimberly. Give yourself to the dance.
I am. I will.
That's it. Let me mold you. I won't desert you like your mama did. I'm here for you now, and I always will be.
Kimberly finally nails the choreography and falls to the floor.
Did I? Was I?
Yes. You're one of my beautiful fallen angels now.
Interior, ladies' room. Beleth comes out of the stall and goes to the mirror. She starts washing her hands. Becky Lockery comes out of another stall.
Becky, honey, what are you doing here?
What? I'm not allowed to come. I paid for my tickets already, didn't I?
I explained to you there's no refunds for these kinds of events, even if your child is
dead. You want to finally say it, or should I?
I think you just did. Listen, Becky, I do not want to have a scene in here with you. I just dropped a deuce to clear my head, and I need to be getting back.
Listen, I'm not doing nothing. I'm here for my daughter, and Jim would want me to be here, so.
I'm sure she wouldn't, so. Now, if you'll excuse me.
I won't never, Belleth. There ain't no excuse for you. I know you know what happened to Gemma, and I'm beginning to think you had something to do with it.
Me? I love that girl. I love all these girls.
Tell that to someone who ain't posting flyers and flowers sometimes when I feel the need down at the Piggly Wiggly looking for my girl. And if there's a God somewhere, I hope that he takes mercy on your soul, because I know I won't never will.
You sound ignorant. You hear how many negatives you got in there?
Not more than you, Belleth. Not more than you.
Interior Morningstar office. Patty Beth sits in a chair, horrified.
Patty Beth, we should go. This is a crime scene now, and I don't want either of us to go to jail for something we didn't do.
I did this. Christ! I made him come here. This is all my fault.
All right, but now we need to go.
There's a rumbling in the inner office.
Oh, God. Do you think she left that dog in here? What if it ate some of Lee?
What dog? What are you talking about?
Miss Francine.
The old owner? No, she's dead.
Patty Beth opens the door.
Holy shit, she's not.
Miss Francine, 80s, a chain-smoking grand dame in a wheelchair, covered in her own filth, emerges from the darkness of the office.
Close your mouth, Patty Beth. You look like a tard. Where's Belleth?
They're at regionals. Miss Francine, we thought you were dead.
Would have been easier, but I got a tough old constitution. And try as they might, neither one of them devils was going to do me in. Who's this?
Hi, I'm Allison. I'm Kimberly's mom.
Oh, you the witch. They've been whispering about. They was real happy to get their hands on you.
I don't really consider myself a witch. I see myself more as a healer.
Can it, hippie? I don't need to know your damn life story. We all in grave danger now. We need to get regionals before it's too late.
Miss Francine, we can't go like this. I mean, no offense, honey, but you smell real bad.
Of course I do. Bella's had me locked up in that office for almost 3 years now, living off TV dinners, surrounded by my own filth.
Not just surrounded, though, right? A lot of it's still on you.
Oh, you smell me, is that it? But you smelled something else too, didn't you, witch?
The fire, the burning, that was you?
No, that was him. That's his unholy mark, but only those with the magic can recognize it. I knew it in the day that Mr. Jeremy appeared in this place, and that's why he had to go get rid of me.
What are you saying, Miss Francine?
Mr. Jeremy is the devil.
I would say he's more damaged.
No, I mean the actual devil, woman. Beelzebub, old Nick, Satan. I mean, it's right in his name.
Jeremy Atans. Oh, I see it now.
Listen, we need to get to regionals before he opens the gates to hell and kills us all.
But y'all make such a big fucking deal out of regionals.
He's using them girls to open the gates of hell. Five dancers, 5 points of the pentagram. His choreographer is all a spell to bring the coming of the end of the world.
A children's dance show. Why do you people think this is so important?
Patty Beth, leave us for a minute, would you?
Sure thing. I'll bring around the car.
You know, something wasn't right about this place since day one. Why won't you believe yourself now?
I'm trying. It's all so much for me.
It'll all be too much when the gates to hell are opened and torment rains down on us all. Now grab my Necronomicon, let's go.
You have a Necronomicon?
Every dance studio has 2 things, a large supply of hula hoops and a Necronomicon. And thank God for it.
Interior stage later. Miss Kitty Belvers, 30s, takes the stage still walking in a pageant from many years ago.
Well, good afternoon, y'all. I'm your host for today, but I'm sure y'all knew that. Yeah, I'm sure you also knew that I'm still the reigning Miss Shreveport. Because they discontinued the contest in 2007 due to a lack of interest. But I am here today, and I'd like to thank the wonderful people at La Quinta. Aren't they wonderful? Now, before we go any further, I think I would be real remiss if I didn't talk about the elephant in the room. And no, I'm not talking about Miss Doretta from Achieve Your Dreams.
Oh my God, she died. That's too soon.
Well, I'm real sorry to hear about that. But I need to talk to y'all about some recent allegations made against me in the Cotton Valley Penny Saver. Now, first, I am not, and nor have I ever been, a quote-unquote furry. Okay. And second, I don't even know what a blumpkin is. Okay.
Belleth rounds up the girls.
Girls, this, you know, this woman's doing it's called a bit, and I don't think y'all should listen. So why don't we get all y'all outside to get a breath of fresh air?
And yes, I do like a little cocktail, as I'm sure most of you do.
This is a children's dance concert.
Yeah, and you're drunk. So how do you like me now? All right, now let's get this thing moving along, okay? I want to go home and watch me some bones. All right, so first up, from Gina Rett, it's the Razzles of Miss Beverly's Dance World.
The dancers take the stage as Beleth moves the other dancers outside. Exterior hallway at the hotel. Beleth has the girls.
Okay, Michaela, where are you? Michaela, honey, Michaela, you feeling all right?
I need my bag. I think my popsicle is melting.
Honey, what's your popsicle? What's your popsicle? Does any of y'all know? Does anyone here know what she's talking about?
Maybe she's getting her period.
Oh, Jesus. Okay, well, Kimberly, will you take her?
I need my bag!
Well, Miss Lurline has it, and she's up on the mezzanine for the cocktail shrimps hour, okay? You think you can make it up them stairs, girl?
I'll take her. I don't mind.
And that is why you're our little captain, Kimber. Now, all y'all can learn a thing from her, okay? Hurry on back now. We're going to be going on soon.
Interior, Allison's car. Allison drives with Patty Beth in the front seat and Miss Francine in the back.
Now, repeat after me. Confutatus mulleribus.
Confutatus mulleribus.
Good. Now, Christo Inferente.
Is this really going to work? I mean, we're trying to vanquish the devil.
Would have been a great day for Fudgy. Too bad Lorelene killed her.
What? No, she had a...
No, she didn't have no peanut allergy. They was poisoned, and they was meant for you. Ain't you even figured that out yet?
Me? Why would Lorelene want to kill me?
Because Kimberly was made captain. I mean, shit, it's right there.
This is all Mr. Jeremy's doing. What he's made y'all become is an abomination worse than gay marriage.
Okay, seriously.
Ignore her.
Don't ignore nothing. We are fighting a battle between good and evil that could lead to the end of the world. Sorry if that hurts your little dyke feelings.
Oh, we're not dykes.
Don't bother me none what you is as long as you listen to the words I'm telling. Now again, confudestish.
Confudestish,
stupid.
Ish, stupid.
Exterior, La Quinta Wet Bar. Michaela and Kimberly get off the elevator.
I'm sorry, your mama's not here, Kimberly, but at least she's not dead.
Sure. Now let's look for Miss Lurline and get you all cleaned up.
Why? What I done?
Michaela looks all over herself.
Your popsicle?
A popsicle? Oh, I love a popsicle.
Kimberly cranes her neck to look for Lurline, who is eating fried shrimp. Kimberly rushes over to her.
Hey, girls, what y'all doing up here? Oh, you come to get some shrimps? Because I put some in this bag to bring down for y'all anyway.
I need my bag.
Oh, sure, honey. What's the trouble?
She was talking about her popsicle, and I thought she meant her period.
Makes sense. Fudgy used to call relations playing squirrels.
I want my bag. I want it.
Okay, calm down, little miss. You can't be pulling me like that.
I want it. Give it to me now.
In one big move, Michaela pulls the bag and swings Lurline to the edge of the stairs.
Now, your mama taught you better than this, Michaela. What would she say if she saw you acting like this?
Lurline is very close to the edge of the staircase without noticing.
Push.
Exactly. Wait, what?
Lurline relaxes and Michaela pushes her in the bag down the stairs. Lurline falls down the stairs, breaking her neck.
Michaela, what have you done?
Stairs is evil.
Michaela skips away as Kimberly follows after her. Interior, La Quinta reception. Patty Beth wheels Miss Francine and Allison, and they go to the deck.
Now lay low. I don't want Mr. Jeremy to know we're here until it's too late.
Oh, my Lord, it can't be. Miss Francine, is that really you?
Yeah, who are you?
Sean Rumper, you remember me?
Yeah, you ever get your passes right or are you still worthless?
You always was a kidder. I'm here competing. In fact, my girls just finished and they did real good.
I bet. We don't have time for whatever this is. We're looking for Mr. Jeremy. You seen him?
Not yet, but I'm real excited to. He's such an artist. How funny that he went to work for you.
Funny? No. But if you're looking for something real comical, I start with a hairline and work my way down. If you'll excuse me.
She didn't mean it.
Yes, I did. Now push!
Interior backstage later, Mr. Jeremy is going over the cues for the music as Belleth adjusts the costumes for all the girls.
Oh, Ramada, honey, you got a stain on your leotard. Damn it, how did this happen?
Sandy.
Shut up.
Well, maybe, you know what? Maybe Lurleen has a Tide stick in her bag. Did she tell you when she was coming down, Michaela?
No.
Tell me what?
Y'all ever heard of a straight line or what?
You don't do anything straight.
Yeah.
See, this is why people hate us. Now, where the hell is Toby? Okay, he must be getting weak, being so far away from the studio for so long. You gonna make it, Toby?
Yes, master. I'll try.
Oh, shit. We gotta get these kids on now! Anyone back here know what time we're going on?
Miss Kitty is drinking a flask from her bag.
Sure thing. Now, which ones are y'all?
MorningStar, Dance Academy, and Modeling. Memorize it, because you're going to be saying it a lot later on when you're giving out them trophies.
Sure, yeah. Well, there's two more acts before you. First up, there's the Lilydale Hustlers, and then there's the Tattle Wangers. They're from Natchez. I have to follow the schedule.
Who says? They're both shit anyway. I mean, a number to Uptown Funk. Gag me.
Well, I guess I could make an adjustment. That is, if I was given some incentive.
All right. Belleth, go down on this woman.
Okay.
Money is also good. Better even.
All right. Pay the local celebrity and be done with her. We need to get Toby on stage before it's too late.
Oh, but you know what? Lurleen has my wallet in her bag. I mean, she's probably still upstairs getting shrimps.
No, she's not. She's dead.
What?
She fell down the stairs. We saw it.
And you didn't say nothing?
Of course she didn't. She was thinking of the team, weren't you, Kimber?
Yes. I'm sorry, Fendi.
My mama is dead.
Baby, I got you. I'm here.
Get off me. God is punishing me, punishing us.
What?
And all this time, I thought Michaela was the dumb one. You listen up, Fendi. Ain't nobody punishing you. Your mama is challenging you right now. She's putting a huge obstacle in your way, huh? Knowing that you can handle it. And what are you going to do about it, huh? Throw away this opportunity and suck because boo-hoo, my mama's dead? Or are you going to pick yourself up, get out there and dance like your life depended on it?
But it doesn't matter if she's already dead.
So what? She just died in vain? That's up to you now. And if you're really worried about this whole lesbian thing, I can tell you firsthand, God don't care. He's like everyone else. The idea seems hot, but when you see the real thing in action, it's not.
Fendi, baby, let's do this. Let's do this for your mama.
I will.
Master, I'm getting tired.
All right, these kids gotta go now.
Hey, Miss Kitty, honey, you don't happen to take Discover, do you?
I'm a furry. Of course I do. Okay, now y'all's is up next, and I'm ordering some hot wings in the room tonight.
Exterior, La Quinta Banquet Room. Allison, Patty Beth, and Miss Francine enter from the back of the room.
Good, they haven't started yet.
Now, I know this might look different than what y'all's got in y'all's programs, but these little darlings, they was just so eager to show you what they got. I couldn't resist. You know, side note, does any of y'all know if the Hooters around here delivers? All right. Anyway, without further ado, from Baffomette Parish, we have the Five Alive from the MorningStar Dance Academy and Modeling.
Miss Kitty gestures and all the kids enter the stage.
Get in your positions. And no matter what, keep repeating what I told you. It's the only way we can destroy the circle.
Destroy? But our kids are in that circle.
Move! We don't have much time.
Miss Francine wheels herself down the center aisle as Patty Beth moves to the right and Allison moves to the left. On stage, the kids go into their routine. Interior backstage, Belle F and Jeremy watch as the team go through the routine.
Shouldn't something be happening?
No, not yet. There's one last step needs to be taken. The gates to hell can't be opened without a blood sacrifice.
Oh, are you going to kill one of them on stage?
No, Belle F, I'm not.
Mr. Jeremy takes out a knife and slices Belle F's throat. She falls to the ground.
I'm sorry, Belle F, but I'm sure you imagined it would come to this.
I did not.
Belle F dies as her blood pools near the dancers. The room starts vibrating.
Ooh, it's working.
Interior banquet room. Allison looks around as the room starts to vibrate.
Miss Francine!
Keep saying them words, witch.
Confutatius, pluribulus, mentis reum fortune.
Mr. Sean is watching as the room is trembling.
A man is a showman. I will give him that.
Interior backstage, Mr. Jeremy looks out at the stage, not understanding why the gate isn't opening. He peeks through the curtain and sees Miss Francine.
Oh, a fucking course. Why won't you just fucking die?
Mr. Jeremy starts using his powers. Interior looking to ballroom. Miss Francine continues to whisper an incantation as the storm in the room becomes more and more violent. Suddenly all the plastic forks, knives, and toothpicks perk up on everyone's plates and off the floor. In one move from Mr. Jeremy, they all fly at Miss Francine. She's killed in a hailstorm of dirty white cutlery. Allison and Patty Beth reach out to her, but there's nothing to be done. The storm gets worse in the room and everyone starts to freak out. Suddenly a crack forms in the floor and red hellfire spews forth.
Learn from this, Sean. This is where your work needs to start going.
The room is in chaos as Allison runs over to Patty Beth.
I don't know how much longer I can keep holding on. He might just be too strong for us.
We need a third. Everything good comes in threes. Where are we getting another witch now?
Becky Lockery enters the hall from the back.
Becky! Over here!
She runs over to them.
I know I've had one too many, but this room's shaking for anyone else.
What are you doing? I know this woman. She ain't no witch.
No, she doesn't need to be. It's just energy. And we're unblocking it. You can do that, can't you, Becky?
Like an enema?
Sure, but seriously, you people need to think of a new metaphor. Now, follow my lead.
Interior backstage, Mr. Jeremy watch on his plan as his plan is taking hold.
Finally, the world is mine. Hellfire will rain forth on Earth once again. Oh, and I'm going to fuck shit up. Trust and believe on that. 4 more years. No Broadway. And every Riverdale spinoff I can dream up.
Suddenly, the storm starts to calm a bit.
What's happening? What's going on?
Mr. Jeremy goes out to the stage. The La Quinta Ballroom. Mr. Jeremy takes the stage and the children dance around him in a trance.
Okay. What the hell y'all think you're doing?
We're shifting energies. We're breathing. We're visualizing.
Oh, cut the shit. Y'all know who I am.
We do, but we're looking at you as a victim of your own trauma and that's someone who's deserving of our compassion. Right, girls?
You betcha.
Anybody else thinking about Chai? Anybody know what in the hell that is?
Oh, compassion? Is that it? How about now?
Mr. Kimberly picks up Kimberly by the neck.
Put her down!
Watch me.
Mr. Jeremy dangles her over the crack, leading to hell.
Hell is coming to this land whether you like it or not, and there's nothing you can do about it.
Maybe not, but they can. Michaela, baby, it's Allison, and no matter what, we all love you, and we think that you are great.
Ramada, baby, I'm here. It's Mama, and I think you deserve all the happiness in the world.
Bandy, it's Mrs. Lockery, and to be honest, you seem like a real little bitch, but even bitches need love, right?
What are y'all doing?
The girls start waking out of their trances.
We do, and I'm finally opening myself up to it.
No, stop it!
Kimberly, I am watching you dance, and you look wonderful.
You are? That's really all I ever wanted.
Now stop this nonsense. These children need discipline.
They don't. They just need a little love. And to not take all this shit so goddamn serious.
That's it. It's just dancing, for Christ's sake.
Mr. Jeremy starts to diminish. He drops Kimberly to the ground. She gets up and dances all by herself. For the first time, she is truly terrible.
That's my girl.
Toby. Toby, help me.
Yes, master.
Toby turns into stone and falls into the hellfire. Mr. Jeremy starts to sink himself.
Y'all think you whooped me? You ain't done nothing of the kind. I'll be back. You bet you I will. You just wait.
Mr. Jeremy falls through the crack in the floor. The crack disappears and everything in the room is settled.
It is.
He took my Gemma, didn't he?
He did.
Thank you. I'm gonna run and see if there's any of that shrimp bar left.
Ramada runs off stage to Patty Beth and hugs her.
Oh, Mama!
Honey, are you all right, honey? Are you all right?
Mama, I'm sorry. And I'm gay.
Oh, honey, I know. I've seen your forehead. And I love you no matter what.
The room is still as everyone starts to sink back into reality. Mr. Sean is sitting in his seat, still unfazed.
The man is a showman.
He gets up and applauds loudly.
Get up, you idiots. You just seen a masterpiece. Get up!
The whole room erupts into applause and all the girls take a bow. Allison mouths, I love you, to a smiling Kimberly. Kimberly mouths back, Mom, stop. Exterior, La Quinta parking lot. Allison and Patty Beth walk all the girls out to the car.
Oh, Mama, I have something else to tell you. I have a girlfriend.
Oh, sweet. It better not be Finny, because y'all is half sisters.
What?
Well, she only said half.
So, what's your plan, Mary Beth? Patty Beth.
Well, these kids need minding, and I guess I got that big old house to look after now with Laureline gone, too.
I think she'd want you to have it.
No, she wouldn't, but that'll be half the fun of living there. What about you?
Well, that's up to Kimberly. What do you think, Kimberly? Do you like it around here?
I don't care.
I think that means yes.
Kimberly's mom? Hi, I'm Michaela.
Yeah, honey, I know that.
I live here. Here. Can I go to there?
Well, honey.
Now you're coming to stay with me, Michaela. We'll put you in one of them rooms downstairs. No stairs for you.
Okay. Oh, you're going to have to write that on the other side of my neck then.
Patty Beth walks off with Michaela, Fendi, and Ramada. Kimberly and Allison are alone.
Mom? I was good today, wasn't I?
No, you sucked. And that's okay. Maybe we can try something else.
What about joining a band?
Wow, you're just full of terrible ideas. You're really your father's daughter. Now, let's get home. I want to open the Fresh Direct box before the raccoons get into it. You know, I think I'm going to like it here after all.
Whatever.
Epilogue. Interior MorningStar studio. Later. The whole strip mall is silent as Gemma comes to the door.
Somebody? Anybody? Mama? I'm here. Y'all, I'm back. Okay. Ah, fuck it. She probably forgot me anyways.
The end. Yay! Everyone come back on. Hooray! Thank you everyone for joining us. Oh, look at all these beautiful faces. Thank you to these amazing actors. Thank you to Justin Sayre, Casey Deal, Luis, all of the friends, all of you who donated. You can still donate at Sweet Nail Prod so we can get some people out of jail. Thank you for joining, and we all love you very much. Justin, anything else you want to say? Are you here?
Justin? No, just make sure you donate, and we'll be back next month with a new play.
Yay! Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.